Hi everyone, Ulysses here again from Microchip Technology. Welcome back to Ask Our Experts. We are talking about platform firmware security again, and to help answer our question, we bring in Brandon Weekly. Unfortunately, we're all aware that there are bad actors out there that try to hack devices to steal information. Brandon, what security risks and protections are associated with firmware?
So just like the scammers that we all know about that will try to get you to click on malicious links in your email, there are also hackers out there that will try to compromise your platform at the firmware level by injecting bad code in there that can do anything from spy on your platform for months on end to making it so that it can't boot entirely. A couple of examples of this type of attack are called bootkit and rootkit. And the scary part about them is that they actually operate under the operating system. So any antivirus software that you might have on the platform won't be able to detect it because it's running on the firmware rather than the software level. Fortunately, we have solutions out there on the market called root of trust solutions that help combat this type of attack. One thing that they do is when the system is booting up, we exist in parallel with it, with the application processor, and make sure that each line of code as it's running on the application processor is authentic and signed by the original manufacturer of the device. That way, if a hacker tries to inject malicious code in there, it will get flagged because we weren't able to actually sign it properly, and we will simply fall back on an image that we know to be good. One solution that we have, the latest one that's from Microchip, our latest platform root of trust solution, is called the CEC-17-3X Trust Shield. It has this secure boot feature, as well as a large collection of other security features that will not only make sure that you're protected in the pre-boot environment, but it will also make sure that you are protected from malicious code during runtime, and then also protect your device after you reach the end of life stage.
Thank you, Brandon, for helping us understand how platform firmware should be protected. Viewers, to learn more about Microchip's portfolio of platform root of trust solutions, click the link in the description below. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to be the first to know when we have more insights from our experts. We'll see you next time.